Hey and welcome to this video. Today I want to show you the displaced wireframe effect. First of all, go with your clip into the fusion page. Now you have to disconnect the connection between the media in and media out node. Now highlight the media in one node and press shift and spacebar at the same time. Search for image plane 3D. So select this image plane option and press add. Now it's really important that this arrow is green and not yellow. So now drag and drop a background node from above here into the node field. And in addition to that, you drag and drop a merge node into this node field. Now try to connect the background node with the merge node. And now try to connect the media in one node with the merge one node. And here it's really important that this arrow is green. Left click the merge one node and press shift and spacebar at the same time. Search for Displace 3D. Select the Displace 3D node and press add. So now try to connect the merge node with the Displace 3D node by using a green arrow. Now you have to connect the image plane 3D node with the Displace 3D node. And between those two nodes there should be now a yellow arrow. Now you have to highlight the Displace 3D node and then press shift and spacebar at the same time. Search for Merge 3D. Then click on Merge 3D and press add. Now highlight the Merge 3D node and press shift and spacebar at the same time. Search for Camera 3D and press add. Again, left click the Merge 3D node and press shift and spacebar at the same time. Now search for Renderer 3D. Select Renderer 3D and press add. And yes, we are almost done, so go to Renderer 3D and press shift and spacebar at the same time. After that, search for Soft Glow. Select Soft Glow and press add. And now you have to connect the Soft Glow node with the Media Out node. As we can see, we don't see anything yet, but this is about to change. So now you have to go to the Image Plane 3D node. And here you change the subdivisions from 10 to 800. Now go to the Displace 3D node and change the scale from 1 to 0.17. Now go to the Renderer 3D node. And here you change the renderer type from Software Renderer to OpenGL Renderer. Now go to the Soft Glow node and decrease the gain from 2 to 1. Now go back to the Image Plane 3D node and left click the wireframe box. After this go to the Merge 3D node and press this left view button. And wow, you can see this 3D dimension and you can zoom in and out by pressing Ctrl and by scrolling with your mouse wheel. And you can change your POV of this 3D field by pressing Alt, your mouse wheel and by moving your mouse from the right to the left. So, and now I go from the image plane 3D node to the camera 3D node. And now our goal is that we change the position of our camera because our camera is in the video and we can't see anything, as you can see here. So I zoom a little bit into the camera position and with this blue arrow I drag the camera out of my video. And we can see in the right window more and more of our video. For now the camera position is too low and that's why I have to change that with the green arrow. So now the effect is almost done and now I want to explain what you can adjust. So what's really interesting for you is that you can on the image plane 3D node change your subdivisions. So the subdivisions divide the video into many small squares. And if you increase the subdivisions, your video will be divided into more small squares. So if your subdivisions are more than 1000, then you can't barely see any of these squares. But if you want to decrease the subdivisions to 200 or 300, then you can clearly see the net of squares. So I would recommend a subdivision range between 800 and 1200. After that you can change an important thing on the Displace 3D node. So here you can change how much these white parts will stick out of your video. And here you can see the length of the white parts in the 3D dimension. And you can do this with the scale slider. So now decrease the scale a little bit. And as you can see here, the white parts become flatter. And here you can also see that the white parts doesn't stick out anymore. And now I will show you how it will look like when I increase the scale slider. So as you can see, the white parts stick out much more than before. And yes, for sure, this looks crazy. You can also change the parts that will stick out of your video by changing the channel type. So with the Luma channel, only the white parts of your video will stick out. And with the red channel, only the red parts will stick out. But I prefer the channel type Luma and the scale range between 0.1 and 0.2. And the only thing that is left is the soft glow. So now you can decide with the gain slider how much the parts that stick out will shine. So if you increase the gain slider, the video will be very bright. But if you decrease the gain slider too much, then you won't see anything of the parts that are sticking out. And that's why I recommend a gain range between 1 and 2. And the effect will also be improved by changing the glow size to 0 or 1 or 2. That means that your glowing parts in your video will be more sharper And with this adjustment, your glowing parts won't look blurry. So I hope this tutorial has helped you. If so, then leave a like or sub to my channel. Thanks for your attention, stay creative, and bye!